So, hi.
Hi.
When did you get to Brazil?
24 hours ago, I think.
Oh, so you've been here longer than I have. Okay.
Okay.
Do you remember your first impressions while reading the script, and what were your first thoughts on Know Me?
I had to read it a couple times to figure out what was happening. That's honestly what happened.
Yeah.
And then, I mean, I was super stoked on it. I mean, the second that I read it, I said to myself, don't fuck this up. You have to get this part. Like, this is you. Do this. Get it.
Did you get to read the script before you auditioned?
Three of them.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so wait. So I'll go.
Okay.
Jessica Jones has just launched a few weeks ago. How has the response been so far? Were you surprised by any type of reaction or comment?
It's been completely insane. The response has been amazing. I always felt like the show had so much potential to be really groundbreaking, and I feel like it is everything that I wished it would be and more. And the kinds of conversations that it started around women and power and consent.
Yes.
And some of the heavier issues that the show deals with.
Oh, I'm one of those people. I love the show. I watched the whole thing in, I think, 3 days. It's amazing.
Wow, amazing.
And I really love the conversations that it's starting too, like especially about consent. So going off of that, this seems like a turning point for women in the entertainment business. How do you see Jessica in the midst of it?
Jessica is such an original character, and I think maybe that's why people are digging it. That's why I love her. I love that she is just a misfit, you know? She's
yes.
a misfit in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, but also we haven't really seen a female lead like her. But there, you know, I feel like there's amazing shows out right now with amazing female leads, and it seems like sometimes the conversation is like, oh, there has never been another female-led
yeah.
show before, but there have,
yeah.
and there's amazing
yeah.
stuff going on. Weeds, Nurse Jackie, How to Get Away with Murder, Scandal,
yep.
and I think that, and Homeland, I think that Jessica Jones fits in there, and she's just so...
Agreed.
She's definitely marching to her own drummer.
I love that. I love her drummer.
Thanks. Me too. So what was the most amazing thing about playing Nomi?
For me, it was being able to play a character who is trans, written by someone who is trans. That authenticity brought to that character
yeah.
for me is just beyond, and it's resonating so deeply with the audience, like they're really appreciative of that. So for me, that's just through the roof.
Yeah, so you've gotten to travel around the world.
Yes, yes.
Does everybody travel around the world?
Yeah.
Or different parts mm-hmm. of the show?
Yeah, no,
countries?
Everything's on location. So like I went to 7 of the 9 cities.
Wow, that's crazy. How long was the season? How long does it shoot?
6 months.
So you're just straight up living out of a suitcase for
yep.
7 months.
Yep, just gone. Just a suitcase and hotels and fruit from room service.
Yes, totally.
And just living it up.
And was everybody in the same hotel?
Yeah.
So it was like camp.
Yeah,
you were
it
like
totally was.
In the circus.
Oh yeah, except there was alcohol.
Oh, got it. That's so rad. What a unique experience.
I know, I'm so young.
Okay, I have another one.
Okay.
If your life was made into a movie, who would play you?
Ooh, okay, well, let's say that it okay. Ooh, Tilda Swinton.
Ah! That's a good one.
Please.
She's amazing.
She's amazing.
She's amazing.
So, are there any female characters you remember watching and thinking, I want to be like her?
Yeah, I like Jessica Chastain. I also liked her in Most Violent Year. But, like, when I was younger, like, career goals, I loved Gina Davis in Accidental Tourist.
Okay.
She's super quirky.
Yeah. Bryan Cranston recently got very emotional talking about your character's death scene in Breaking Bad. Did you know at the time it had such a strong impact on him?
I knew that this scene had an impact on him, like on the day, because of how he played it and how it affected him. And but I certainly didn't know or realize that that was going to be such a pivotal moment and a turning point in the show and a turning point for his character. I certainly never thought that it would be kind of this iconic scene. Everyone leading up to shooting that was feeling like really sad. Oh my God, it's gonna be so sad. And for me, I was just like so excited to be in like the death makeup.
Yeah.
They gave me like lividity and like I looked disgusting. And
you were like, yes.
It was so fun. It
yeah.
wasn't until we shot the scene where I was actually dead and Aaron Paul was like trying to revive me.
Yeah.
But I was like, oh my God, this is so hardcore. Like, this is what would happen if I were dead.
Like, rolling you onto your side and like, oh God, no. It was great.
I feel like so incredibly fortunate that I got to be on that show and I got to work with him because he's amazing. Like, he is very inspiring. He'll talk to you about acting and auditioning. He's just one of those people that's very generous with his time and his ideas, and he's so passionate.
So important.
So that was an amazing experience for so many reasons.
All right. Well, I have to say, after this interview, I do trust you. I trust the bee.
Oh, yeah, you should trust the bee. Or should you?
I don't know, maybe.